Hi everyone, welcome back to Christina Land, a place for grown-up gift givers and adult toy collectors. If you've seen any of my videos, you know I have an unhealthy obsession with Rapunzel. Especially, Tangled. I love the movie Tangled. And the animated series, it's so good. Anyway. So, I kept debating and debating because, did I need another Rapunzel doll? I mean, who needs another Rapunzel doll? One of these days, I'm gonna, probably actually sooner or later, I think I'm gonna go through all my Disney Store Rapunzels to compare them all to you because there's differences, you know? Is what I've told my husband. Anyway, I realized as I was debating that Mulan was no longer available, the storybook version of Mulan. And so I'm like, well, I have to get Rapunzel then because no, this dress is not accurate, but look how pretty the sleeves are. And then she comes with this second dress. And a frying pan. And I have a lot of pastels now, but also a pastel and a guitar, which I already have several guitars. And I actually really liked the flower clip in her hair. I really like that. I think it would have been nice if she came with like a lantern. That would have been something different, but it is what it is. And then I was also debating, should I get her because she supposedly liked the wardrobe Rapunzel set. If I can find a stock image, I'll put it here, that I have, which we'll do a comparison in this video if she is the same or not. But once I saw that Mulan was out of stock and then there's another of the storybook dolls that are out of stock, I'm like, oh, I have to get her. I have to get her because I will be so upset. Like I am about the first Dracula's ultimate secret doll that I never got. And now it's too late. But it's okay. I will move past it. I'll move past it. So, how do we open it? Oh, okay. This is not how we open it, but it does, in the back there's activity, which you probably know, but I didn't know. Activity scenes, activities you can do on the back. There is this nice portrait of Rapunzel that you can color. Oh, that actually is really nice. And then we also open it this way, the front, so let me show you her. She'll either be the worst Rapunzel or the best Rapunzel. Why the worst? Because I saw several comments that her limbs completely snap off. Just completely snap off. And some of these are adult collectors who said they snapped off. So I am nervous. And we'll see what happens. And then she's in her tower and her backdrop right here, which I'm not gonna keep, but that's cool they have it, is like flowers, like I think on her wall, the wall of her tower. I'm gonna open her up and we'll look through all of the different accessories and then the doll and hope that her limbs don't snap off. That only took 3 minutes to open, pretty easy. The doll in her dress, you can see in the packaging, just easy to take out. The rest of her stuff was in a box on the side, wrapped in tissue paper. So I'm going to assume these are all her accessories, so we'll go through them. We have two pink flat shoes with molded on bows in the front. I'm not sure why they're flats when they gave this doll heels. Well, I guess there's like... it's like the teeniest heel, kind of like a wedge, but look more flats to me. Doesn't quite make sense. We have her guitar, all molded plastic. It is a yellow color with some black designs, some red designs. The neck of the guitar is a brown. The top part, which I totally don't know what it's called, is yellow with a little bit of like molded on brownish red strings. There's no strap or anything for her to hold it, though. We have Pascal, who looks like most of the other Pascals lately from the Disney Store. Oops, don't fall, dude. Green with blackish brown stripes on top. Brown eyes. Focus. And his tail is kind of curled. This really pretty goldish headband that has painted pink and purple flowers. I don't know how to quite get that on her since she has a flower clipped in her hair, like the tie in her hair, but we'll see. And on the back, it's not painted, just gold, muted gold color.
I know this is super silly to be excited about, but she has a frying pan. I have wanted Rapunzel to have a frying pan for forever, and it has a handle so she can hold it. Yay! Very exciting.
A doll. She has very pale skin, freckles, green eyes, dark blonde or light brown eyebrows, depending on how you want to look at it, blonde hair with a fabric pink flower that is attached in a tea tie, or I was trying to like see what the flower is attached to and then it kind of fell off one of its things, so I'm not going to mess with it. But it's a flower that's attached somewhere to her hair because I want to keep that on. Her hair goes past her ankles just the littlest bit. Her dress is not an exact replica, but it is, you know, close. It has purple and pink sleeves. And then she has these nice Renaissance accordion ruffle pink sleeves past the short purple and pink sleeves. One thing I don't really like is that her corset is printed. Like, the ribbons are printed, whereas I think all the other Rapunzel dolls I have from the Disney store, it's actual ribbon. But nope, this is printed. She does have a real ribbon at the top. And then she has a purple skirt with a very glittery pattern and flowers, leaves, just different designs that are featured in Tangled. And like I said earlier, she does have high-heeled feet. I personally like it when Rapunzel has flat feet because she never wears shoes, so why does she need heeled feet? That's just my opinion. And she comes with this really pretty pink dress that has short sleeves, and it has really pretty white ruffling on the bottom of the sleeves, also around the collar area. White flower design in the front. On the bottom portion of the dress is different designs that Rapunzel has painted in the movie. On the edges of the dress, pink flowers, blue bird. And then she has this tulle glittery feeling overskirt on the outside of it. Oh, there's also edges around the dress going to the back of different things that Rapunzel has painted. So that's actually really nice. All right, we're gonna look at articulation and hope that her arms don't snap off. She can look to the left, to the right, a little bit up and down, a little bit to the sides, a little hard though. She can move at the shoulders. Oh boy. Oh. Okay, at the elbows. Oh, let's do the other one. The elbows, at the wrists, good. Do the other one, okay. And then she just has, I think the bend and snap knees. So rubbery legs and bend and snap knees. Before I put her in her second dress, let's compare her to the wardrobe Rapunzel and see if she's any different. I really do like this dress with the like the Renaissance style ruffled accordion sleeves. They're just so pretty. I think I wish they would have been a little longer. Then they would really would have been Renaissance style, but okay, the Disney Store storybook Rapunzel is on the left. Her lips are a little bit more pink than the one on the right, the wardrobe one. And I think the Rapunzel Disney Storybook dolls' eyes are a little bit bigger. Do they seem a little bit bigger? And the eyebrows are the teeniest bit different as well. I think the Rapunzel the Storybook one has a little bit of a higher forehead. Like, her forehead's just a little bit bigger than the other one. The freckles are also a little bit lighter on the Storybook one. Also, interesting, the storybook one, I don't think this is for classic Rapunzel, the storybook one has like a little indent in her neck, whereas there is no indent in the wardrobe Rapunzel one. And then the wardrobe Rapunzel one has flat feet, where this one has the high heel feet. Which do you guys like better? I honestly can't tell. I am going to keep the flower in this Rapunzel, though, so I know that at least. I don't know. Let's change this Rapunzel into her pink dress now, though. Oh, and also, if you could tell, like I was saying, all my Disney Store doll Rapunzels have ribbon. So this is actual ribbon in the wardrobe doll, not just painted or printed on. Which at the time when I got the wardrobe doll, well, I think her list price was $35. I got it on sale because my Disney Store was closing. But it's interesting that she came for $35. Granted, this was obviously 2018, 2019. She came with a wardrobe, with like hair clips, a stool. I don't remember. I'll put a picture here because I don't remember what she came with. I think when I do my comparison of all my Rapunzel dolls, I'm going to like, you know, first show them all dressed, but then take off their clothes as well so you can kind of see just the differences in body types, because I think they've changed over the years. In fact, I wonder if this Rapunzel might be different than this one. You know what? We're going to do a little bit of doll nakedness because I think the body type of the new Rapunzel and storybook one might be different than the wardrobe one. So a little bit of doll nakedness coming at you because now I need to know. And oh, there's so much glitter on this wardrobe one because her top of the dress is so glittery. Don't like glitter. Nope. Oh, and I kept the tissue paper on this one. So we'll just take it off. So much glitter. Why do we do glitter, Rapunzel? You don't know? That's fair. Okay, yeah, interesting. Yeah, I probably should show you as opposed to looking at it myself, huh? So as you can tell, the wardrobe Rapunzel, and I think even the classic Rapunzel now, is much thinner at the waist and even the torso a little bit than this Rapunzel. And yeah, even this Rapunzel, the storybook one, her legs are even stockier than this one. How about her arms? Her arms too are a little bit thicker than this one. Interesting. One interesting thing to me is that wardrobe Rapunzel's hair goes past her feet, whereas, again, this one is a little past her ankles, so interesting. Very interesting. Now, I don't have the original Disney Store Rapunzel that first came out because I didn't see Tangled until maybe 2012, and then when I saw it, I was like, oh my gosh, this is the most amazing thing ever. Completely obsessed. So here is Rapunzel holding her frying pan, which I'm so excited about, in this dress, the pink dress, and then on her pink shoes. I tried fitting the shoes on my wardrobe Rapunzel with the flat feet. Her feet were too big, so I couldn't fit the headband on her because the flower was in the way, and I didn't want to get the flower off because I really like the flower on her. This is a really nice pink dress on it. It looks lighter in my camera, but it's not quite as light as it looks in real life. I did put the flower headband on the other Rapunzel, just so you can kind of see how it should look, which I really like that. It's really pretty. I just don't think I can use it with this one because of the fabric flower, and I don't want the flower to get out of her hair. Yeah, I like this dress. It's pretty. I like both dresses, honestly. With the joints, I think just kind of before you give them to a child or before you play or picture them, just kind of, you know, work them a little bit, just very carefully. And I think it should be okay if you just, you know, at first just kind of work them. Oh, she can also bend at the waist. I didn't say that. I was focused on like her arm joints, so she can do that too. I like her. I'm really glad I have her. I think she is different enough than my wardrobe Rapunzel, especially seeing that, yeah, her body type is very different. I like that she came with two sets of clothes, because usually they just stick Rapunzel in that purple outfit and call it good, but I like this. I like that I finally have a frying pan for her to hold. And if you haven't been able to get Pascal before, or guitar, she has it. I wish it came with a strap. One of my Rapunzels has a guitar with a strap. I think the singing one I have. I put the guitar away, though, so I can't show it to you, but I think that one came with the strap. Let's see, maybe she can kind of hold it. It might take some finessing, but Probably eventually she can hold it. I think I'm gonna put the other dress on her.
Oh.
Well, her flower came out. Which, honestly is kind of why I wanted to get her, because she had that cool flower on top of her and it came out. And I don't ever remember what it looks like on her now. Oh, Christina, Christina. We can pretend it's still on. Okay. That's a little sad, because I really liked that and I wanted to keep it on, and there it goes. Well, anyway, this is her without the hair, the flower. Well, now I can put the flower crown on it. On her. You know what? No to the flower crown. It's tangling up this Rapunzel's hair. You know, I almost wonder, should I just take this little, like, hair band out? Because I tried putting the crown in it, and then it got some of her hair already out. So, should I just give up and take it out and let her look just like this Rapunzel? You know what? We're gonna do it. We're gonna do it. This is a good note that if you want the flower in her hair, it might not stay. Well, you can still see the, like, how it was. I still think this Rapunzel's face is different. I don't know which one looks like more like Rapunzel though. Let me know in the comments below which one you think. And please note, if you get this doll to keep the flower in her hair, it might come out. I think she looks more like Rapunzel without the like the hair up though. And without the flower, so. And I'm so glad I have her because of the dress. I just really like these bell accordion kind of sleeves. And because of the second dress, and she has a frying pan, and no flower in her hair though. No, 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 no. That's gone. But you know what stayed on through it all? Her shoes. Her shoes stayed on through it all. And you know what? They actually kind of work with the dress, actually. I don't think they would, but they do. Of course, with the flower gone, you can kind of see how her hair is not necessarily that thick. It's pretty thin. Pretty thin. Let's see. Does this one have... I think the wardrobe one has thicker hair. Yeah, this Rapunzel has thinner hair. So, there's that. And no flower. Have I mentioned there's no flower in her hair anymore? Just in case you didn't know, there's no flower in her hair anymore. it is what it is. That's okay. If I ever really, really want to get a flower with her Rapunzel in her hair, I guess I could get the classic one. Of course, then I will have even more Rapunzel dolls that my husband says I don't need, so. Will I do it? We'll find out. Until then, I'm glad I have her. I like her two different dresses. I think her new body type is interesting. I did like the flower in her hair, but it is no more. I like her frying pan. If you don't have Pascal, this is good to get with Pascal, or you want a guitar, this is good to have a guitar. Oh, right. I could put her flower crown in her hair. Did I say that? I don't remember, man. One thing about the flower headband, it gets the hair really tangled, so, tangled, get it? I didn't mean to make that pun. But be mindful of that. So here is the flower crown in her hair. Oh, that looks really pretty. That looks pretty. I like that on her. Yeah, I you know what? I think I'm actually glad the flower came out because I like the flower crown on her. I think it looks really nice on her. So that will be it for Rapunzel. Eventually I will do a comparison to all the Disney Store Rapunzels I have. The blonde ones, not the brunette. And we'll see which one is actually the best Rapunzel doll. Now, I don't have the original 2010 Rapunzel doll with the, like, really long hair and the tinsel in it because I didn't watch Tangled until 2012, and that's when I started collecting Rapunzel. So many Rapunzel items. So I don't have the original, so I can't compare with the original. The original doesn't look like her at all, like, really at all. And she has weird green in her eyes. If I can find a stock photo for when I do the comparison of all the dolls, I will. But, like, it doesn't look like Rapunzel. Like, yeah, it's the most accurate outfit, and she has long hair, but, the doll. Yep. Anyway, okay, back to this Rapunzel. I am glad I got her. I am okay now that the flower came out. I think she actually does look a lot like Rapunzel. Let me know in the comments what you think. Have you bought this Rapunzel? Did your flower come out? But still, the shoes stay on, man. The shoes stay on. Please like this video if you liked it. Please share with your friends if they're curious about the storybook Rapunzel doll, which so far is only on Shop Disney. Sometimes it goes on Amazon for the normal $30 price. Sometimes. So I don't know how much it is if you don't live in the US, but her list price is $30 USD. So, but yeah. Okay, that'll be it for this video. Remember, it's okay to like what you like, be who you are, and stay young at heart. And we will see you in the next video. And now we're gonna wave. She says, come on. There we go. Bye.